The question number 1 of 9.2 exercise, we have given A, B, C, D as a parallelogram. Correct? I am just making that parallelogram. So A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. It is given. And A perpendicular to DC. We will drop a perpendicular AE. This is a perpendicular AE to DC. Another CF perpendicular to AD means CF. CF perpendicular to AD. This is perpendicular CF. Perpendicular to AD. AB length is 16. This length is 16 centimeter. Correct? Another thing is given, AE is equal to 8. So this is 8 centimeter, this one. Correct? And another is given, CF is 10. CF is 10. This is 10 centimeter. Correct? And we have to find the value of AD. This is our requirement. Solution. So we know that area of parallelogram ABCD will be is equal to base into height. Okay. So first we are going to take height as base as AB. Means base as AB, or you can say CD, or AB or CD are same because opposite side of the parallelograms are equal. And height I will take AD. Is it okay?
Yes.
So AB is equal to 16 and A is equal to 8. So you will get, this is the final value of, I am not going to multiply because I need to divide it again. So also you have area of a parallelogram A, B, C, D. Now I am going to take base as AD and height as FC. And AD is not given, but FC is given 10. So this is again the same area, centimeter square. So you know that the area of the same parallelogram will be same. Therefore, AD into 10 will be is equal to 16 into 8. This implies AD. Here is AD. AD. So therefore, AD will be 16 into 8 divided by 10. You will get 1 to 8 over 10. This is 12.8 centimeter. This is the answer. So once again, I am just revising what question is there. We have A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D as a parallelogram. This is a parallelogram. And E, F, G, H are the midpoint of respective sides. And when we will join these sides, you will get another quadrilateral. So we want to prove that the area of EFGH, we have not given the name of the shape, will be half of the area of a parallelogram ABCD. This is we want to prove. Now we will take a small construction. Construction is join HF. We are going to join HF. Is it okay? When you will join HF, now come to the proof. Proof of this question. So, since H and F are the midpoint points of AD and BC, yes or no, respectively. Therefore, DH will be half of AD and CF will be half of BC. Correct? Now, as ABCD is a parallelogram, therefore, we know that the opposite side of the parallelograms are equal and parallel also. Yes or no? Correct? So, if these sides are equal, their half will also be equal. AD by 2 is equal to BC by 2. Yes or no? Yes or no? And half will be parallel also. Correct? And what is the half of AD? Half of AD is DH and half of BC is CF. So therefore, add DH parallel to CF. So DH is equal to CF and DH parallel to CF. So therefore, DHCF is a parallelogram. Correct? So similarly, we can prove that AB FH is also a parallelogram. Samajh gaye? Now see here, like if DHFC is a parallelogram, so parallelogram DHFC and triangle GHFC have same base and between same parallel, so their area will be, area of the triangle will be half of the area of the parallelogram. So I'm just writing this one as parallelogram DHFC and triangle GFH have same base. What is the same base? HF. And between same parallels, what are the parallels? HF and DC. So therefore, we know the result. If a triangle and a parallelogram have the same base and between the same parallel, then area of triangle GFH will be equal to half of the area of parallelogram DHFC. Put this is equation number 1. So similarly on other side, the area of triangle EFH will be equal to half of the area of ABFH. Okay, similarly, we can prove that area of triangle EFH will be equal to half of the area of parallelogram ABFH. Put equation number 2. Now by adding adding equation 1 and 2, we get area of triangle GFH plus area, left hand side will be added to the left hand side, triangle EFH will be, right hand side will be added to the right hand side, half is common. So area of parallelogram DHFC plus area of parallelogram ABFH. So the area of a triangle GFH and EFH will be is equal to area of EFGH. Yes or no? And half is outside. The area of parallelogram, this and this will be area of parallelogram ABCD. So this is the required result, hence proved. Now the next question is, we have given ABCD is a parallelogram. We have given ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. And P point on DC, there is a P point here. P point on DC and Q point on AD. Q point on AD. Correct? And we want to prove that, to prove area of triangle APB is equal to area of triangle BQC APB, this, correct? So PBQC, we want to prove this. Now proof, as parallelogram ABCD and triangle APB have same base which one? AB. Okay, and between same parallels, which are parallels? AB and DC. Correct? So therefore, the area of triangle APB will be half of the area of parallelogram ABCD. Equation number 1. So also, parallelogram ABCD and triangle BQC have same base. Which one of the base? BC. And between same parallels, which are the parallels? AD and BC. Therefore, area of triangle BQC will be half of the area of parallelogram ABCD. Question number 2. So therefore, from equation 1 and 2, so in equation number 1 and 2, right hand side equal. So therefore, left hand side will be also equal. So area of a triangle APB will be is equal to area of a triangle BQC. Equation number, hence proved. This is the answer. There is a question number 4. We have given ABCD is a parallelogram and P is any point interior of a parallelogram. Interior means between here, anywhere, maybe somewhere here. Okay, there is a point P. This point is P. Correct? And you can join this point with A, P point with D, P point with C, P point with B. We have to prove triangle ABB means APB, this one. Area of triangle APB and area of triangle PCD, this. Sum of these area is equal to half of the parallelogram. That is the one thing. Another you want to prove, area of APB plus area of DPC is equal to area of a triangle AB means sum of area this plus this. This is our requirement. Correct? So we will consider, we will take one line, take line through P which is parallel to AB ja DC. Correct? So this is means draw construction. This is a small construction. Draw a line through P which is parallel to AB. Okay, you can take these point lies M and you can say any other R. So proof is as MR parallel to AB, correct? And AM parallel to BR, because we already, so therefore AMRB is a parallelogram. So therefore, as parallelogram, which one? AMRB and triangle PAB, or you can say APB, have same base and between same base. Which one is the base? Base is AB. And between same parallels. Which are the parallels? AB and MR. Therefore, area of triangle APB will be is equal to half of the area of parallelogram AMRB. Yes or no? Correct? So equation number 1. So similarly, we can prove that area of triangle DPC will be is equal to half of the area of parallelogram MDCR. Okay, MDCR. Yes or no?
Yes.
So equation number 2. So adding 1 and 2, we get. So left hand side will be added to left hand side, right hand side will be added to right hand side. Left hand side is the area of triangle APB plus area of triangle DPC will be is equal to this parallelogram plus this parallelogram will be half is outside, will be is equal to area of parallelogram
ABC.
Yes, ABCD. Question number 3rd. And this is the first result that we want to prove. So second result, we know that in the second result, we know that second one, we know that area of parallelogram ABCD will be equal to area of all four triangles APB, DPC, APD, CB, CPB. Yes or no? Will be sum of all these four triangles. Correct? So I am just noting area of triangle APB plus area of triangle DPC plus area of triangle APD plus area of triangle CPB. And you know that this area we have already proved equation number 3rd is equal to half of the area of the parallelogram ABC. When you will take this value on other side, so here on other side you have a complete area of the parallelogram. So if you will subtract this from this, you will get the half. Means here you have, so this is left, means you have a area of triangle APD plus area of triangle CPB, means these two, correct, will be is equal to, on right hand side we have a area of a parallelogram ABCD, and this plus this is the area of half of the parallelogram. So when you will take on other side, it will be minus half of the area of a parallelogram. Okay, half of the area of the parallelogram A, B, C, D. So when you will subtract this area from this area, what will be the left? Half. Correct? If you will subtract the half area of the parallelogram from the complete, you will get half of the area balance. Parallelogram A area or parallelogram A, B, C, D. So this is the question number 4th. Now in 3rd you have sum of these area is equal to this, and in 4th sum of these area is equal to same. So right from 3rd and 4th, from 3rd and 4th, right hand side same, so left hand side will be same. So therefore area of triangle APB plus area of a triangle DPC will be is equal to area of triangle APD plus area of triangle CPB. This is the second result, hence proved.